The major development in the cracking problems that have forced the Inner West light rail line to be shut down. Lachlan Kennedy has been speaking with transport officials. Lachlan, what can you tell us?
Sandra, in what has been described as a worst case scenario, the line will be shut for a year and a half. That is because the cracks that have been identified in the entire fleet, all 12 sets of trams that operate this line between Dulwich Hill and Central, well, those cracks are a lot worse than expected and first anticipated. We heard at a parliamentary hearing on Tuesday the transport officials thought maybe this line might be shut down for a month. Well, after closer examination today, they've realised it will not be a quick fix and this will be shut down for up to 18 months. Here's what the Chief Operations Officer of Transport for New South Wales and the Transport Minister said a short time ago.
This is like the wheel arch of your car, the inner wheel arch where the wheels sit. There are significant cracks up to 20 to 30 centimetres in length.
The problem we've identified is likely to be far broader in scope than just here in little old Sydney town. It's likely to be a global concern.
A global concern, but also these trams are operated in Newcastle and the ACT, meaning inspections will have to happen there. On a normal year, this line carries 10.7 million commuters. The state government has offered an apology to all of them, an unreserved apology, in particular HSC students who will soon face more delays. A fleet of Sydney buses will become a permanent fixture, replacing the light rail services here. Sandra, as for who's going to pay to fix all this, well, the Transport Minister says it will not be the taxpayer, meaning there could be legal action down the line.
All right, Lachlan, thank you.